Welcome to my engineering drawing playlist. Today I will be explaining tangent method for the parabola. Here you can see these are the different methods for the parabola. In the last video we have discussed about the rectangle method. Next we have discussed about the parallelogram method. Now it's turn for the tangent method. So let's start the tangent method, that is sometimes known as the envelope method also. Now let's see the description of the problem. Draw vertical axis parabola. If the base and axis length are 7.5 meter and 3.4 meter respectively. So here you can see you have to draw the vertical axis parabola. So here you can see this is the vertical parabola. And here you can see this is the base and this one is the axis length. That is given to you here 7.5 meter and 3.4 meter respectively. Now let's solve the problem step by step with the instrument. Here you can see it is in meter and that definitely you cannot accommodate in your drawing page, and so that you have to take the scale which is reduced scale actually. So here I am going to take the scale as 1 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. That means my drawing size 1 centimeter represent as actually 1 meter. And so that you can say RF is equal to 1 is to 100. So first of all, draw the horizontal line, that is 7.5 meter is given to you as the base length. And here we have taken the scale 1 meter is equal to 1 centimeter, and so that you have to draw the horizontal line is 7.5 centimeter. So here you can see 7.5 centimeter. So mark the point. Now give the name as AB. And here the dimension is given to you in the description, so that definitely you should mention it in your drawing. Keep in mind that in the drawing you have to mention the actual dimension of the object. And actual dimension is given to you as 7.5 meter. So it should be 7.5 meter. Mark the midpoint of this AB line. Now draw the vertical line passing through this E point, and that is exactly given to you as 3.4 meter. That is the axis length. So set it 3.4 meter. Here you can see. Once again, keep in mind that this is in fact actual dimension. But in the drawing page, it should be with this scale. That's why it is now 3.4 centimeter. So mark it over here, one point, and give the name as F. So now you can imagine your parabola must be passed through this 3 point. So it will be like this. So in order to draw this parabola perfectly, you need to follow all the steps. Here in this description, this EF, that is actually the length 3.4 meter. So I am going to mention over here 3.4 meter. Once again, see over here what the dimensions as per the aligned system. So you have to follow any one dimensioning method in the drawing. Now you have to extend this line EF in the upward direction. Initially take the length of this line randomly. Now take the compass, set the radius that is exactly equal to EF, then take E as the center, draw the arc over here so that you will get the intersection point. Mark it as O point. So keep in mind that OF, that is exactly equal to EF. So definitely you can take this distance with the help of the scale as 3.4 centimeter also. Now next join OA and OB. Now here you can see this is the triangle. So that sometimes this method is also known as the triangle method for the parabola. Now divide this OA distance into the 5, 6 or 7 equal parts. And at that time you can follow this special method to divide the line into the equal parts. So the length should be such that you can divide easily equal parts. So here I am going to take the length as 90 mm, and here you can see I can divide it easily into the 6 equal parts. Here you can see each division having 15 mm length. Now join end point of this line with the O. Now set the roller scale with this line, and then you can draw parallel to this line passing through these all points. So definitely you will get all the lines parallel, so that you will get equal division here. So keep in mind that this is actually the method to divide this OA line into the equal parts. Definitely you can skip it in the examination if you are able to divide OA distance into the 4, 5 or 6 equal parts with the help of the scale. Then draw the horizontal line so that you can divide this OB into the same equal parts. Now mark the point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 here. Now mark the point over here 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash and 5 dash. So the numbering should be in the ascending order, see, and then from here to here in ascending order. Now join 1, 1 dash, 2, 2 dash, 3, 3 dash, 4, 4 dash and 5, 5 dash. Now the very important point, draw the curve such that these all lines must be the tangent to the curve. So see carefully. So here you can see this curve with the red color is actually parabola. So here keep in mind that all these blue lines are actually the tangent to this parabola. That's why it is sometimes known as tangent method. So this is your answer. Draw vertical axis parabola. Here it is vertical axis parabola. That means your parabola is in vertical position. You can draw it in horizontal position also like this. Then it is called as the horizontal axis parabola. At last, how can you draw the normal and tangent in this problem? Write your answer in the comment box. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate it.